There is no secret that Nights into Dreams is one of my favorite games of all time. So when I found out there was a sequel on the Nintendo Wii, I was extremely excited to play it. I remember this being one of the games that pushed me to get a Wii in the first place. Now that I think about it, Sega has some really good content on the platform, but Nights was definitely the surprise I did not see coming. When this game came out, I remember putting it down rather quickly, and I don't really remember why. Maybe it was due to the motion controls or how the game felt to me at that time. So now that I'm reviewing this game for this channel, I am looking at it from fresh eyes, and I must say, there are some great things here. Let's talk about it. So first off, Knight's Journey of Dreams is definitely more story focused than the previous title. The game has full voice acting, cutscenes, and more. Now the game still follows two children, William and Helen. Both children are having personal issues within their lives. Will has a passion for soccer, but his father is constantly going away on business trips. And Helen is a very talented violinist, and this is how her and her mother bond. Now that Helen is getting older, she is getting away from the violin, and that is causing a rift in her and her mother's relationship. Now in the world of Nightopia, Wiseman and Reality are back and causing all sorts of havoc in the dream world, and it's up for Will, Helen, and Knights to put it into all the madness. Now, personally speaking, I think the story works well for the game. The voice acting is not bad and definitely adds to the element of storytelling. Knights' voice does lean more to the feminine side, and seeing that Knights is an androgynous character, I can see how one could assume that Knights would be female if they did not know that fact. Now, that's not an issue for me at all, just something that I noticed while playing the game. I also like how the game expands on Knights as a character, explaining how the children become one with Knights and how Knights was once a henchman for Wiseman. Now for the gameplay. I love the fact that there are more than one gameplay style this time around. You still have the traditional flight gameplay that Knights is known for, but there are also different challenges for each of the stages. The levels are broken up into different acts, similar to Mario Galaxy or Sonic Colors, and you complete the challenges within the acts to move on. This can range from collecting gems coming out of a volcano, hitting the music notes with time, or simply building up your ring combo. Knights also has persona masks that allows you to transform into different things while you play. You unlock these as you progress to the game. You have a dolphin for underwater action, and even a dragon for wind resistance, and much more. The game also has small platforming sections for the children. Nothing special here, but I do applaud Sonic Team for giving the children something more to do than just being a vessel for Knights. The stages look really good, but there's just not much going on here. The children control pretty standard for a 3D platformer, and they attack using the chips, you know, the blue orbs that you find all throughout the game. These are used to stun and defeat enemies to take them down and move on to next sections. Now, the bosses in this game. I actually really like the design of many of these bosses, and the fact that each has their own unique gimmick is pretty cool to me. Some of these bosses, though, are super annoying. Prime example, Chameleon. He is a chameleon that hides in darkness. In order to defeat him, you have to find him by paralooping all over the place, which is not an easy task. I also was not fond of Bomamba, another boss with an annoying gimmick. And the design is kind of terrifying. Now, the stages themselves and the designs are great, and considering this game came out on the original Wii, it looks absolutely amazing. Despite the frame rate stutters here and there, this game would look amazing if it was given a second chance on the Switch in HD. I mean, one can dream, right? Stages like the City of Nightopia and Pure Valley were just a joy to watch and play through. I also love the city skyline levels at the end of the game when you fly as one of the children. Visually, it is great and one of the best looking games I've seen on the Wii. The music. Do I even need to say anything about this game's soundtrack? All I need to tell you, go to your favorite streaming platform right now and listen to this OST. The Hub World music was all I needed to hear to let me know the soundtrack was going to be amazing. As far as overall presentation, Knight's Journey of Dreams is a top tier game on the Wii, so props to Sega. Now, as much as I admire this game, there were some things that I was not too fond of during my playthrough. First off, I hated the fact that you had to start the entire level over if you lost to a boss or even accidentally fell off a platform during the children's sections. Since this game has no checkpoints, you really have to make sure you're on your A game the entire time. I also felt the game got a little repetitive with some of the missions and the repeated tutorials. Not a huge complaint since this game is pretty short, but still. Overall, I am ashamed that I missed out on this game for so long. It did not necessarily recreate the magic of the original for me, but this is a damn good follow-up. I really believe if this game got ported to the Switch, this would have a chance of more people showing Knights more love. If you have a Wii or Wii U, give Knight's Journey of Dreams a shot. Definitely a standout title on the platform. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see you next time.